name would be. You were praying prayers and bringing dreams for me from the day I came into your life. You must have known that I would learn to love from you. And the love deep in my heart long ago, the kind of special touch that only a mother could know. What started as a tiny seed now grows and grows in me each day. For you planted a love in my heart that will
show you how to do this.
Mm-hmm.
And good afternoon. We gather as God's family on this beautiful autumn day to celebrate this loving union of marriage between Brad and Kimberly. We're very proud of that. We're very happy for them. We ask God's special graces to be with them as we celebrate this very special day. And so may the grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. And let us pray now. Father, you have made the bond of marriage a holy mystery, a symbol of Christ's love for his church. Hear our prayers this afternoon for Brad and Kim. With faith in you and with faith in each other, they pledge their love today. May their lives always bear witness to the reality of that love. We ask you this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Please be seated now for our readings.
Bless our souls who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. Reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only begotten Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In this is love. Not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God, yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Because when you leave these doors of this church, You have no idea what lies ahead. And there's a lot of hope in each other and together as a couple. And there's much love. But a time of dying, is that true? Well, sure it is. Because if you look at what love exactly is, it's a giving of yourself to one another as a husband and wife, putting aside some of that individuality, dying to it, so that a new life can rise from our celebration today. The life of Brad and Kimberly together. And so the challenge is set out for you. One of the most overused words we have is that of love. We use it for tennis, right? We use it for different feelings that we might have. But when I look at a husband and wife, love is a commitment. Love is a choice. And it is a choice that you make each and every day of your lives together. When you wake up in the morning, when you go to bed at night, you choose to love each other. And that choice is present in so many different ways. In some of the small things we do for one another, in the ways, in a sense, we put aside what we want for what our couple wants together. Love is a choice, and it's a dying to oneself. Jesus prayed that in the gospel reading, that they may be one in us, that he gave us an example of what love is all about. Greatest love we have for another is to lay down one's life for the other. Jesus showed that on the cross. And a husband and wife do that each day when they choose to love. Dying to yourself so that you can rise to new life as a committed and happy couple. And so the challenge is set before you. You can't do it on your own. Believe me, you can't. It takes God's grace. It takes a closeness to our God. It takes two people growing together in faith and in hope so that they can truly grow together in love. So the challenge is set up before you. We prayed in that opening prayer that marriage is a holy bond, a symbol of Christ's love for his church. That's what hopefully you two will become for us, a symbol of Christ's love for his church, so that when we look at Brad and Kim, we not only see people that we love as family, but something far greater is present. You become a reflection together of Christ's love for his church. Be that mirror, and you will find the joys and happiness that marriage can bring. We're proud of you and we're happy for you. And if you don't remember anything I said today, just remember that that love is a choice, and it's a dying to yourself, so that together as a married couple, you truly rise to a new life in Jesus. Well, God bless you. I ask the bridal couple, bridal party to come forward now. The rest remain seated. One of the things that does happen occasionally in a wedding is that occurrences happen, whether it's a little one doesn't make up the aisle, or whether all of a sudden, for unexplained reasons, the lights go out. But you know something, it's one of those things that it's a part of marriage. to adapt. So if they go out again, I'm not an electrician, I have no idea what's happening. I hope it's not an omen from God. No, I just teach it. But the key thing is, if they go out again, don't worry about it. Okay? It's one of those things that are part of marriage, that you learn to adapt, and you have to adapt. Alright? So come on forward. Brad and Kim, you have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of me and the church's minister, in the presence of your family and friends. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He's already consecrated you in baptism, and now he wants to enrich and strengthen you by another special sign, another special sacrament, so that you may assume the duties of marriage and mutual lasting fidelity. So in the presence of all of us, I ask you now to state your intentions. Brad and Kimberly, have you come here freely, without any reservation, to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives? And will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church? Since it is your intention now to enter into marriage, I ask you now to declare your consent before God and his church.
I, Brad, take you, Kimberly, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
I, Kimberly, take you, Brad, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you.
And you have declared your consent now before God and his church. What God has joined together, people must never separate. Lord, we ask you now to bless and consecrate Brad and Kim in their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of their true faith in each other and always remind them of their love. We ask these things in Christ our Lord.
Kimberly, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Brad, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Oh, Father, these are our words of prayer today for ourselves and all human beings. Tomorrow there will be others. You have first loved us. Give our words by your listening the power of your word so that all things may be accomplished sweetly and gently for the happiness of all. And so we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I give you peace, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grant us the peace and unity of the kingdom where you live forever and ever. And the peace of the Lord be with all of you. Thank you. Let's offer to each other a sign of God's peace and his love. church's special blessing that we call the nuptial blessing.
Things do happen.
Let us turn now to the Lord, pray that he will bless with his grace Kimberly, now married in Christ, to Brad, and that he would continue to be united in love this couple that he's joined in this holy bond. Father, by your power, you have made everything out of nothing. In the beginning, you created the universe and made humanity in your own likeness. You gave man the constant help of woman, so that man and woman should no longer be two but one flesh. And you teach us that what you have united may never be divided. Father, you have made the union of man and wife so holy in history that it symbolizes the marriage of Christ and his church. Look with love upon Kim, now joined Brad in marriage. She asks your blessing. Give her the grace of love and peace. May she always follow the example of the holy women whose praise is sung in the scriptures. May Brad put his trust in her and recognize that she is his equal and the heir with him to the life of grace. May he always honor her and love her as Christ loves his bride and church. Father, keep them always true to your commandments. Keep them faithful in marriage. And let them be living examples of Christian life. Give them the strength which comes from the gospel, so that they may be witnesses of Christ to others. Bless them with children and help them be good parents. May they live to see their children's children, and after a happy old age, grant them fullness of life with the saints in the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. May God the Father, Almighty Father, give you his joy and bless you. Amen. May the only Son of God have mercy on you and help you in good times and in bad. Amen. May the Holy Spirit of God always fill your hearts with his love. Amen. And may God's blessings come upon you and all of us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Now my privilege to present to you our newly married couple. Brad and Kim Weishaupt.
body with the toughest of the tough. I can laugh in the face of all my insecurity. Say the word and tonight I will follow you anywhere.